In this lesson, we'll discuss how to find the relationship between two pi groups through conducting experiments. In previous videos, we discussed how the pressure drop per length of pipe, delta PL, is a function of several variables. If the flow through the pipe is steady, incompressible, isothermal, fully developed, then turbulent, and the pipe wall is smooth, delta PL is some function of the flow speed V, pipe diameter D, fluid density rho, and the fluid's absolute viscosity mu. Applying dimensional analysis, we found that we could study this system using two dimensionless groups of variables called pi groups. The pi group delta PL D over rho V squared is some unknown function phi of the Reynolds number, rho V D over mu. So how can we find the function phi? Well, here's one possible way to find phi. We place a smooth-walled pipe of known length and diameter into a pipe system where we can drive the water through the pipe at a constant flow rate using a pump. We will assume that this test section of pipe is placed far enough away from the pump, the flow is fully developed by the time it reaches the test section. We can use two pressure gauges to measure the pressure drop across the pipe, as shown in the diagram, or use a single differential pressure gauge. Let's say the length of pipe is 5 feet, and the inner diameter of the pipe is 0.496 inches. Water at 60 degrees Fahrenheit flows through the system, and at that temperature the density is 1.94 slugs per cubic foot, and the absolute viscosity is 2.34 times 10 to the minus 5 pounds force seconds per foot squared. We can adjust the volumetric flow rate Q, which varies the Reynolds number, by opening or closing a valve. The volumetric flow rate is measured by a flow rate meter, such as a Venturi meter. Since the volumetric flow rate is equal to the flow speed V times the cross-sectional area of the pipe, A, we can calculate the flow speed. Let's say we conduct an experiment where we vary the flow speed from 1.17 feet per second to 28.73 feet per second and take 8 measurements. At each flow speed, we measure the pressure drop over the 5-foot test section of pipe. For example, when the flow speed is 1.17 feet per second, we measure a pressure drop of 6.26 pounds force per foot squared. This is the pressure drop over the entire test section, so we divide this value by 5 feet in order to obtain the value for delta PL, and we get 1.25 pounds force per foot cubed. When the flow speed is 28.73 feet per second, we measure a pressure drop of 1730 pounds force per foot squared. We divide this value by 5 feet to obtain delta PL, which is equal to 346 pounds force per foot cubed. We now can calculate the value of the two pi groups at each flow speed. When the flow speed is 1.17 foot per second, the first pi group is 0.0195 and the Reynolds number is 4010. When the flow speed is 28.73 feet per second, the first pi group is 0.00893 and the Reynolds number is 98,500. Notice that the lowest value of the Reynolds number is above 4000, so the flow in the pipe should be turbulent for all the flow speeds examined. Now that we have this experimental data, we can find the functional relationship between the pi groups. We can use some software, like Excel, to plot the dependent pi group pi 1 versus the independent pi group pi 2. Then we can try to apply a best fit curve to this data. Now, simply by looking at the data, it's clear that the relationship between the pi groups is not linear, as a straight line would fit the data quite poorly. You can experiment with different types of curve fits until finding one that fits the data well. In this case, a power law relationship does an excellent job of fitting the data, and the curve shown on the plot is a power law curve. A power law relationship is defined as the dependent pi group being equal to some constant, C1, times the independent pi group raised to some constant, C2. In Excel, a power law curve fit to the data gives that C1 is 0.15, and C2 is negative 0.25. We can visually see that the data points fall along the power law curve very well, which suggests we have not omitted any important variables in our analysis. One way to test whether the power law may provide a good fit to the data is by plotting the data on a log-log plot. The data point should appear as a straight line on a log-log plot if the power law describes the relationship between the pi terms well. So, we've now found an acceptable expression for the function phi. It's important to keep in mind the limitations of this expression. The flow must be steady, incompressible, isothermal, fully developed, and turbulent, and the absolute roughness of the pipe wall must be negligible. Otherwise, this relationship may produce inaccurate predictions for delta PL. Additionally, we only varied the Reynolds number between 4010 and 98,500. The expression for phi may not be accurate outside this range of Reynolds numbers. If a pipe experiences flow conditions with a Reynolds number greater than 98,500, the pi 1 group may continue to decrease according to the power law expression we obtained, or it may change suddenly. We simply don't know for sure without experimental data at higher Reynolds number values. As a side note, we can relate this relationship between pi groups to the expression for the pressure loss in pipe flow. We multiply and divide the right side of the equation by 2 times the gravitational acceleration g, and recall that delta PL is the pressure drop per length of pipe. We rearrange the equation so the left side becomes the change in pressure head, delta P over rho G. The change in pressure head is equal to 0.3 times the Reynolds number to the negative 0.25 times L over D times V squared over 2G. The term 0.3 times Reynolds number to the negative 0.25 is a decent approximation for the friction factor F for smooth-walled pipes experiencing steady, incompressible, isothermal, fully developed turbulent flow in the Reynolds number range of 4010 to 98,500. You can verify this by examining a Moody chart.